God this morning, loved ones. This is the seventh Sunday of Easter, Sunday, May the 24th, 2020. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. A litany for Memorial Day. Memorial Day, we celebrate tomorrow, Monday, May the 25th. As we observe Memorial Day, we remember the men and women who have sacrificed their lives that we might live in freedom. We honor them and their families who mourn their loss. Let us pray that we may never take for granted the precious freedom that is the legacy of those men and women who died. We pray that we may learn to love one another. God, hear our prayer. We remember those who have loved us enough to lay down their lives for our great country. God, hear our prayer. We pray that you would comfort all those who mourn the loss in war of a loved one. God, hear our prayer. We pray that we may never take the freedoms we have for granted and will share them with others. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray that you will remove greed, envy, and lust for power and control from our hearts and the hearts of all people. God, hear our prayer. We pray that you will root out racism, sexism, and violence from our lives, our communities, our nation, and our world. God, hear our prayer. Our morning hymn will be I'll Just Say Yes by Brian Courtney Wilson. Our adult dance team will be Dancing in Praise. We do not own the rights to the music or the lyrics. Be blessed as you listen to I'll Just Say Yes.
Say yes.
our sins, God, anything that we've done that was not right in your sight, Father. Those things that we did out of our humanity, Father. Those things that we did, Father, that we didn't know was wrong, but was. Teach us, God, to be better people, God. Teach us, God, to follow after you. Lord, our spirit says yes to you. Our spirit says yes. God, we wait with hope, for you are the source of our very strength. God, we wait with patience, for your timing is always perfect. God, we wait with prayer, for you are always listening to us. Father, we wait with praise in our hearts, for you promise to take all of our anxieties as we cast them upon you. Most gracious God, during this time, we pray especially for those graduates with uncertainty in their future, God. Let them know that you will lead them and that you will guide them. Lord, we pray for those who have lost their jobs and are finding ways to meet their financial needs. Father, lift up those who have lost their loved ones and where funeral services are limited or have been postponed. God, comfort their heart. God, comfort those who are fighting against addiction and are unable to meet with their recovery groups. God, even those who feel fear as hate crimes and incidents rise within our communities. During this time, oh God, we call on you and we say yes to your will, Father. Father, enter into our sorrows, our worries, our addictions. God, enter into our financial burdens, our fears, and injustices. Fill us today, God, with your grace. Fill us with your hope. And God, we ask that you fill us with joy abundantly. Father, teach us to turn our homes into a place of worship, into a place of peace and unity and love for each other. God, renew our hearts and minds to seek the knowledge of your mercy and your love each day. God, help our souls to be united in constant prayer with you. God of all creation, in this Easter tide, we pray for all the COVID-19 patients, their doctors, and their nurses. God, we ask that you will be a fence around all healthcare workers, first responders, and their families. God, please expand our faith and our hope, Father, as we learn to shelter in place, God, with you. Lord, teach us how to wait, for you are the God. You are the God of our need. You are the God that fills us with your peace and with your mercy. Father, we ask, Lord, for the prayer to be upon the family and friends of Rapp Avenue A.M.E. Church. Father, of all of our churches, of our Episcopal leaders, of all ministers, laities, and Father, the church body of Christ. God, we ask for prayer for our sick and shut-in, those who are in nursing homes, Sister Joanne White, Sister Mary Porter, Sister Robbie Gill, Sister Jessie Walker, Sister Emma Ragnon. God, we just ask for your grace and your mercy right now upon those, God. Please, God, let us lift up Reverend Ashaya Woods, the passing of her mother, Sister Cynthia Miller, and Tony Towns' family, the passing of his dad, brother, William Skip Towns. For God, we know that you will never leave us nor forsake us, God. Never, God, never. So, God, we are so grateful that you're with us. We're so grateful, God, for your angels that are with us to encamp around us, God, to minister to us in our time of need. And Father, we ask that you touch our heart, our mind, and our souls, God, that we will forever call on you and lean on you, Father, for every need that we have. This is our prayer we ask in the name of Jesus the Christ. Amen and amen. Our scripture reading would come from 1 Peter chapter 4, verses 12 through 14, 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 6 through 11. And the word of God reads, "Dear friends, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal that has come on you to test you as though something strange were happening to you. but rejoice inasmuch as you participate in the sufferings of Christ, so that you may be overjoyed when his glory is revealed. If you are insulted because of the name of Christ, you are blessed, for the spirit of glory and of God rests on you. Humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. Be alert and of sober mind. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. Resist him, standing firm in the faith, because you know that the family of believers throughout the world is undergoing the same kind of sufferings. And the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast. To him be the power forever and ever. Amen. From all that dwell below the skies, let the Creator's praise arise. From all that dwells below the skies, let thy Creator's praise arise. Let thy Redeemer's name be sung through every land by every tongue. The Decalogue, a commitment to keep God's law. Let us express our commitment to keep God's law. God of our salvation, only you are God. We will make no idols. We will not invoke with malice your name, O God. We will remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. We will honor our father and our mother. We will not commit murder or slander. We will not commit adultery. We will not steal. We will not be false witnesses. We will not covet anything that belongs to our neighbor. Hear what Christ our Savior said. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the great and first commandment, and the second is like unto it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets.
Glory be to the Father, and to thy Son, and to thy Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen.
Our scripture text will be coming from 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 12. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, to which you were also called, and have confessed the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Let us pray. Dear most gracious God, we thank you for your presence. Even though we are separate from each other, God, you are with each and every person. Now, God, right now, I just ask that you anoint me, Father, from the top of my head to the soles of my feet, God, that I may preach the word as you have given it to me, God. Oh, Lord, let your anointing fall fresh on those that are listening, Father, right now, Father. Be with them, God. Comfort them, God. Oh, Father, just ask that we lay our burdens down at your feet, God. Father, we rejoice this day, for the word is to come. In the name of Jesus the Christ, amen and amen. In this scripture text, we find the Apostle Paul engaging Timothy. He's telling Timothy that he had other business to do other than to mind the things of this world that we live in. His life was in a state of warfare. He was a soldier. And he was not to entangle himself with the things of his present life. He had many other things to engage in, such as Satan and his principalities and powers, sin and the lust of the flesh, and the world in general. Paul wanted to encourage Timothy to lay hold on eternal life. You see, eternal life is the prize of the high calling of God, which is held up and held forth to those who are fighting the Lord's battle. And it is that we are to lay hold on eternal life. God's word tells us to fight the good fight of faith at all times. We are called to be spiritual warriors in God's kingdom. We are soldiers in the army of God, fighting faithfully with our eyes fixed on Jesus the Christ. Our purpose is to ensure freedom and liberty for those with whom justice cannot be attained. Without these things, we will live under another's dominion. See, in the spiritual world, the battle over world dominion has already been fought and won by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Yet, Satan's time in this world has not ran out yet. We still have to contend with him for a little bit longer until the second coming of Christ. We can't, however, take comfort in that we don't have to fight him alone, nor could we if we even wanted to. We must recognize the weapons of our warfare in this present time and understand how to use them. Jesus promised us the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, as an advocate until he returns. John chapter 14, verses 15 through 17 reminds us, Jesus said, "If you love me, keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to help you and be with you forever, the Spirit of truth. The world cannot accept him because it neither sees him or knows him. But you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you." We must come to believe, to claim, to understand that the Holy Spirit lives within us. And it is that power which will allow us to fight the good fight of faith. The Holy Spirit, our own spirit, has a connection with God. Through the Holy Spirit, our own spirit has a connection with God. Through the Holy Spirit, we find out what God's will is for our life. And it's through the Holy Spirit we come to understand how to accomplish what God has deemed for our very lives. At times, as Christians, we will get tired of the reoccurring battles that seem to want to rear its ugly head at the most inappropriate times during our faith walk. However, we must never give up. We have been equipped with power from on high. Jesus promised us he would never leave us nor forsake us. He is always there, whether we feel like it, whether the situation does not appear to be as it should. Remember, your faith walk is built on believing in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. As children of God, we have been called for an excellent purpose. God's purpose. His purpose is for us to walk as children of the light and declare the good news of the gospel wherever we go, making disciples for Christ. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 through 11 reminds us who we are in Christ. You are all children of the light and children of the day. We do not belong to the night or to the darkness. So then let us not be like others who are asleep, but let us be awake and sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who get drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober, putting on faith and love as a breastplate and the hope of salvation as a helmet. For God did not appoint us to suffer wrath, but to receive salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. He died for us so that whether we are awake or asleep, we may live together in him. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing. Loved ones, we must empower our minds with prayer, fasting, and scripture reading with a renewed mind in order to win over the adversary's threats in our lives. You see, you'll have to come out fighting with the full armor of God each and every day. The enemy will try to stop you any way he can, but the adversary does not have the authority to stop you or I. He will attempt to do so through various means, but he cannot stop a child of God. We find, we understand. understand that spiritual battles are taxing on one's spirit, mind, and physical body. And one may start to think all is lost and they're defeated. But you are not defeated in the name of Jesus the Christ. This is when we must not get tired. This is when we must not get worried. This is when we must not give up in our good fight of faith. This is why the Apostle Paul had a real talk with Timothy. Fight the good fight of faith. You see, a good fight is a fight that you win and are successful through Jesus Christ. That is why you must never give up. You see, the winnings are too high. Quitting is not an option for a child of God. We must realize that we're not defeated, regardless of what the circumstances may even look like. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, 7 through 10 stands to remind us that we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that this all insurpassing power is from God and not from us. We are hard pressed on every side, but are not crushed, perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed. We always carry around in our body the death of Jesus so that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our body. See, Paul tells us that we must be prepared to learn to do battle as a fully trained and equipped soldier of our Lord Jesus Christ. And God equips us for this spiritual battle. He has given us our weapons of warfare that will make us victors in winning others to Christ and victorious in our own personal lives. The Apostle Paul told the Ephesians to equip themselves with the whole armor of God. Ephesians 6, 13 and 18 tells us, therefore take up the whole armor of God that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. Remember, we must be equipped. We have to put on the full armor of God to fight the adversary. You will be victorious. Let us repeat the personal prayer. I am ready to take my stand against the powers of darkness. Please help me to stand against the spiritual forces of evil that want to destroy me, my family, and the church. I buckle the belt of truth around my waist. Help me be a person of truth and reliability. Please give me the words to say when people ask why I follow Jesus. Help me tell about Jesus' death and resurrection and his promise of eternal life to those who believe in him. I take the breastplate of righteousness. Thank you for giving me God's righteousness because I am not perfect. God graciously protects me with his own righteousness because I believe in Jesus Christ. I stand firmly on feet, prepared with the gospel of peace. Help me to resist temptation and stay away from people, places, and situations that tempt me. Help me live in peace with my family and other believers as much as it depends on me. I lift up the shield of faith. Help me to hold up the shield and stop the arrows of doubt, despair, and hopelessness that the enemy shoots at me. I place upon my head the helmet of salvation. Help me to know that no matter how tough life is, Jesus has conquered sin, and I live with the assurance that I will one day be with God in heaven. I use the sword of the Spirit, the Word of God. Thank you for giving me your word, the good news of Jesus Christ. Help me to tell others about him. I will stand guard against the powers of darkness. I will resist temptations and guard myself from vulnerable positions. I will pray persistently for my fellow believers. John 3:16 reminds us that, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Most people think it's difficult to come to Christ, but it really is simple as asking God to forgive you of all your sins and believing in your heart that Jesus is the Son of God. To pray a prayer of faith, to ask God to forgive you and to come into your heart and fill you with his Spirit. God is faithful and a just God, so he would be there right where you are to receive you as his own as soon as you are ready, so that you began your journey with him right where you are right now, this very moment. It doesn't matter where you are in your personal life. It only matters that you want Christ in your life. You see, God will reach way down and pick you up wherever you are. Even right here at your computer, as you look at the sermon or as you read the message, Jesus can be your Lord and Savior right now if you confess him. If you're ready to pray and ask God to come into your life for salvation, say the prayer with me. Dear Lord, I'm a sinner. I acknowledge that I need you to come into my life and to change me. Please, God, wash me and cleanse me of all my sins that I can be in right standing with you. I believe in my heart that Jesus Christ is your Son and accept him as my Lord and Savior. Come into my heart and fill me with your Spirit so that I can live for you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you prayed this prayer in faith and have truly received Christ, you have truly received him. You now have become a child of God. But don't stop there. Don't stop there, because God has so much more in store for you. If you need prayer, call at 502-417-4634 and we will pray with you. Remember, God loves you and will never ever leave you where you are. All you have to do is go to him in prayer. May God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you this day, through this week, as you continue in your faith walk, as you continue to put on the full armor of God. May God continue to bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.